Good morning and welcome to our virtual speech day 2021. It was the best of times. It was the worst of times. It was the age of wisdom. It was the age of foolishness. Charles Dickens's famous opening words from his novel, A Tale of Two Cities, seemed to me particularly pertinent for the times we're living in. With two academic years now affected by the global pandemic, these words resonated. There have certainly been some dark times for our community as we lunge from one government announcement to the next and react to rapidly changing circumstances, not least the impact on school public examinations. But there have also been many positives and lighter moments, new ways of doing things, new ways of interacting with each other, and we've learnt to really value Godolphin's strong community. The pandemic has given us the chance to reflect, to adapt, and provided an invitation to look again at what we do and how we do it. In the best of times, organisations should not stand still, and out of many a crisis can come opportunity and growth, and that's an exciting prospect. The school is in good shape. It is heartwarming and incredibly inspiring just thinking about what has been achieved during the past year in spite of the school closures and COVID restrictions that we've all been living with for some time now. I've spent far more time in front of the camera than I would have liked. I've mastered Teams and Zoom, but perhaps not quite as well as one prospective pupil I had the pleasure of interviewing last term, when she appeared on my screen, complete with a moustache. Her mother too. A younger brother's mischief meant it could not be removed. Our teaching staff and students have been incredibly quick at adapting to this virtual world, and our school digital strategy has moved on apace. We've all upskilled considerably. Students tell me how much more organised they now are too, which is a good thing. The approach to public exams has meant that many students and our teaching staff have had a particularly challenging year. School assessed grades, instead of sitting external examinations, have altered the rhythm of the year and the taught content. Much of the first half of this term was spent helping our students navigate through several assessments. These then had to be marked, standardised and collated alongside a mountain of evidence, all ready for the examination boards to scrutinise. The SAGs, as they are known, have caused anxiety for our students, and we sincerely hope that universities are sympathetic when it comes to the places offered in the summer. With limited occasions to gather together over the past year, we've made the most of pitch one and held services for remembrance and for the National Day of Reflection, marking the pandemic 1 year on. Very sadly, we were not able to take the upper 6th to Westminster Abbey, but they'll get an invitation for next year. And similarly, we've been unable to go to the cathedral for our annual carol service. But the spiritual life of the school has remained important to us. We've been grateful for weekly virtual chapel and many of our staff and students delivering inspirational talks and presentations in prayers. Godolphin has done its best to maintain high standards in art, music and drama. The art department lent out sewing machines so that those doing textiles could continue to work at home. They also provided catch-up sessions for students once we returned after the second lockdown. We're looking forward to the art exhibition in September and reminding ourselves in particular of those outstanding Upper 6th artists gaining places on prestigious courses such as at Central St Martin's and Edinburgh, to name just a couple. The music department have been incredibly inventive, knitting orchestral and vocal pieces together using ingenious software. Vocal Ensemble had the privilege of performing a piece written for them by Judith Weir, Master of the Queen's Music, and regular live streaming of concerts has become commonplace. Much like the country as a whole, it has been a frustrating year for drama, with performances and our main production being cancelled. But smaller productions from Portal and BTEC exam pieces have been of an exceptionally high standard. After virtually a whole year with no sports fixtures, our summer term has been an unusual combination of both winter and summer sports, so that our team sports enthusiasts have not missed out. We've played lacrosse, alongside netball, alongside tennis, athletics, and cricket. We have ambitious plans for September and look forward to the season ahead and a full programme of matches resuming. Interaction with our alumni has continued every Friday during term time, with a host of speakers talking about their journey from school through university and to the many and varied professions that they've now entered. Over this past year, we've also had involvement with several former students concerning Black Lives Matter. As a result of these discussions, we've revisited our curriculum and also heightened awareness of equality, diversity, and inclusion within our own tight-knit community. So what of this year's leavers? What can you take with you into the world beyond Godolphin? Good memories, I hope. Experiences that have shaped the person you are today. The pandemic has disrupted all our lives and especially impacted our young people. Even though you will have had your dark times and moments of self-doubt, we've seen you grow as individuals and seen you respond to disappointments with enormous maturity and courage. My message to all of you who are leaving today, fifth years and upper sixth, is a simple one. We don't know what the future holds, but we can try to shape each day to be positive, creative, exciting and rewarding. Our potential is infinite. As Shakespeare puts it so well, we know what we are, but we know not what we may be. So what comes next? Last Easter, Michael Nicholson stepped down from the board and chairmanship after a considerable number of years of devoted service to Godolphin. I've certainly enjoyed working with him during my 8 years as head. This mantle is now taken up by Sir Nick Pope, and I look forward to working alongside him and the board in a post-COVID world and to shaping a new direction for the school. Thank you.
A very good morning to each and every one of you. Only last week I was planning to make an impassioned and eloquent speech to a sea of expectant faces stretching out into the depths of a gigantic marquee. And yet here I am embracing the more simple but certainly more impersonal digital experience. Let's hope for better next year. In her opening remarks, Emma quoted both Dickens and Shakespeare. I normally turn to Kipling. If you can meet with triumph and disaster and treat those two impostors both the same. I spent much of the last 40 years working in public service. In my old world, values mattered. The British Army teaches and measures its soldiers against a value set which include courage, discipline, respect for others, integrity, loyalty, and in extreme cases, selfless commitment. In retiring from the Army and becoming Chair of Governors here at Godolphin, I've switched from one values-based organisation to another. I hope that we can all agree that Godolphin is a school where girls are valued as individuals and encouraged to develop their own opinions, where personal ambitions can be forged and talents unlocked, where intellectual curiosity and physical challenge go hand in hand with creativity and mental well-being, and where service to others is central to our ethos. The second aspect of my military baggage, which I want to talk about, is the importance of team or family or belonging. And I've quickly discovered that this sense of collective identity resonates as strongly in Godolphin. Whether you're a governor, a member of staff, a student, an old girl or a parent, you are all valued members of the Godolphin community. Although our perspectives may be different, we must each play our part in ensuring that this particular community flourishes. If you like, it's our gift to the next generation. Our founder, Elizabeth Godolphin, believed passionately in teaching students to be able to hold their own in a world that was quite unforgiving. Three centuries later, the context remains remarkably the same. In her opening speech, Emma articulated the extraordinary steps that the school has taken to meet the challenges thrown at us during this COVID-dominated year. My fellow governors and I applaud the superb efforts of Emma, of the senior management team, of staff and of students alike. We too believe that the school is in excellent shape and is well placed to face the future with confidence. In closing, I want to extend my own best wishes to those students and staff who leave today, and particularly to the girls from the Upper 6th. The majority of you will be starting at university in the near future. You will make new friends and face many unexpected challenges. My daughter, Lucy, was in a similar position last year. After lockdown, I took her back to Exeter University in February. 3 days later, her student room was demolished by a previously undiscovered 3-metre-long World War II bomb, which had lain dormant for 80 years. This was certainly an unexpected challenge. And yet her strength of character, nurtured by Godolphin, ensured that she dealt with the ordeal with aplomb.
Hello everyone, I just wanted to send you a short message to say how sorry I am that I won't be with you at your speech day on Saturday. I was so looking forward to coming back to Godolphin. I was there myself back in the 1980s. And I think one of the things I would have wanted to say to you on Saturday is that school life is obviously the most phenomenal educational journey. Challenging at times, tough at times, fabulous and fantastic at times too, and friendships made that will last a lifetime. I still have my closest friends were made at Godolphin back in the 1980s. But I guess the educational journey doesn't end when you leave school. I mean, for me, at my age and in the role that I've been in as president of the National Farmers Union, very much leading our work on net zero, getting to a world where we can produce carbon neutral food within the next few decades. Obviously, government has laid down the target of 2050. I've actually said we can do it by 2040 with the right policies in place. And that has given me a real love of wanting to know more, a thirst for wanting to know more and nail it down into academic knowledge as well. And so I'm very much hoping to do an MPhil in environmental science. So this is the start of your long journey, and you are the young people that are heading out in the world that are going to shape the future, and a lot rests on your shoulders. And life is going to be different, but we will all, I know we don't feel it right now, we will all be better. I think we always are better for hardship that is sometimes thrown at us. You never know what curveballs life is going to throw at you, and this has been a global curved ball that will have ramifications. But you will come through it, and you will be better, and you will be stronger. And I just want to send a very strong message of thought to you all, to those that are leaving, that are those that are still on the school journey. And please do take care, look out for yourselves. And I guess most of all, in these times of change, look out for each other. I think that's really what I take away from this past 18 months, looking out for each other. The whole health and well-being, mental health journey is a critically important one. So have a great summer holidays. I'll be thinking of you, and I hope one day soon that I'll get another invite to come back and see my wonderful old school. Take care, and many thanks for listening to this short message.
It's fair to say that our school could not have kept going over the past 18 months without the dedication and sheer hard work of so many people. Our admin, catering, grounds and housekeeping teams have continued to provide amazing support to your daughters and all our teaching staff. We are extremely grateful to them. It's been a year of rapid change, adapting our habits both outside, but more importantly, inside the classroom. Our teachers have upskilled and delivered an extraordinarily creative and inspiring curriculum, moving seamlessly to online when we had to. As well, we've been faced with additional marking and assessment as schools became effectively the exam bodies for public examinations this year. All of this aside, it's not surprising that we have some teachers who've decided to take a different path post-COVID and leave Godolphin. For many, it is retirement. Others, it is ill health. And for some, the lure of something new and a fresh start. You'll find details of all our leaving staff in the Speech Day publication. But there are some staff I'd like to mention today. From the bursarial team, we say farewell to Jenny Colton and thank her for all her hard work as accounts and payroll clerk. In addition, Judy Wilson retires this year after 19 years of service. Judy has worked for three bursars, three heads and three chairs of governors. From the start, she's looked after new staff joiners, corralled the governors and taken their meeting minutes, being keeper of minibus keys and trip phones, juggled school coach bookings for students and been a valuable and always calm source of inspiration and information for so many around Godolphin. We wish Judy a very happy and well-deserved retirement. Charlotte Smallwood is retiring after 37 years as a teacher of English, including 5 years at Godolphin. What a year this has been to end a career. But even with retirement on the horizon, Charlotte has risen to the demands of online learning and proved herself flexible and adaptable right to the end. With Charlotte's departure, the English department loses a sage colleague whose years of experience have helped to shape and guide recent changes in the curriculum and provide valuable perspective. We will miss her wicked sense of humour and her much appreciated friendship. The students will miss her calm reassurance, her passion and knowledge, and the security of being in a safe pair of hands. We wish Charlotte all the very best in the many retirement adventures she plans ahead. Appointing a chaplain is never easy. Schools and chaplains seem to find each other. That was how Stella Wood came to be at Godolphin. It felt right, and we haven't looked back. Now it feels right for Stella to take up a new challenge as full-time chaplain at Bishop's. Students and staff will miss her enormously, and it's lovely to know she's not far away. Stella is well loved by her students. Her subject knowledge in RS and history is second to none, and this combined with a strong creative streak makes her an outstanding teacher. Stella has also led and contributed to the Oxbridge programme after a number of years, providing much needed support and challenge to our aspiring students. Stella's creativity in the classroom extends to her chaplaincy work too. We've had some inspirational talks, homilies and weekly chapels over the years, and she moved seamlessly to the virtual world, with virtual chapel being a regular feature of school life during the pandemic. Sheep, spiders, and pigs are amongst some of the most memorable topics of her chapel addresses and will forever live in the memory. Speaking personally, it was her thoughtful and well-researched sermons for the annual Westminster Abbey pilgrimage that I shall remember with great fondness. Beyond all of this, of course, is Stella's pastoral work within the school, her core business, as she would describe it. Over the years, there are so many within our community that have benefited from her wise counsel and a listening ear. I see her as the school's conscience and someone who can read situations incredibly well. She leaves with our gratitude, love, and prayers. Nikki Owers started teaching mathematics at Godolphin in September 2007, having previously taught at Norman Court Prep School. She's taught all the year groups during her time here and has shown a real interest and huge skill at teaching some of our students who find mathematics a challenge. In more recent years, Nikki's also taught some economics. Having worked in financial services before taking up teaching, Nikki's skills have made her a valuable member of the economics and business department. Nikki has been a committed sixth form tutor, a role she enjoys, and she helps with the seminar society too. I know she's hoping to spend much of her retirement travelling around the UK and overseas. Huge thanks, Nikki, and we wish you great happiness in retirement. When Catherine Complin joined Godolphin in 2001, there was only one food tech classroom and one GCSE group across the 2 years. Now, 20 years later, there are 8 GCSE classes, level 3 food and nutrition groups at sixth form level, and 2 classes of students taking the Pruleaf catering course. Teaching happens throughout the school. Much of this has been overseen by Catherine in her time as head of department, a role to which she brings her a considerable organisation and planning skills. Something all parents will see reflected in the immaculate folders kept by their daughters. Catherine has a gentle manner and a special way of working with the students, which motivates and encourages them, resulting in them working to the best of their individual abilities. Every good wish, Catherine, for a healthy and happy retirement. We were under no illusions that Sister Jill Davey would be retiring this July. In fact, she's been telling us this daily since she joined in 2006. As well as a well-deserved mention in Tatler and nominated for a BSA award, Sister Jill will always be a legend at Godolphin. Sister Jill is known for her amazing yoga teaching. She has her own YouTube channel, and this certainly kept us going through lockdown. She promises to keep sending us the videos from her seaside view in Scotland. Sister Jill has given so generously of herself and has supported the whole Godolphin community in so many ways. Her no-nonsense approach to first aid training has been appreciated by staff and students alike, and her sex ed lessons are legendary. Please do ask your daughters about them. We will miss you, but never forget you. Thank you for all you've contributed to our community and the kindness and support that you have given to so many over the years. Every happiness for your retirement and for the future, Jill.
Governors, staff, parents and girls, we've made it to the end of the year. Now this might not be how we imagined giving our speech, but here we are nonetheless for a final 10 minutes of nostalgia before we leave Godolphin.
We could stand here and talk to you all about the impact the pandemic has had on our last 2 years of school, but quite frankly I think we've all heard enough about COVID for now, so we'll try not to mention it.
Instead, we wanted to reflect on our time at Godolphin, the things we've learnt, experiences we've had, and to look at what Godolphin means to us. There's a rather common misconception that leaving school means the start of a new life of freedom. However, on reflection, we think that Godolphin has given us more freedom than anything else in our lives.
The richness and diversity of opportunities we have had here, and the lessons that those experiences have given us, as well as the unique Godolphin way of doing things, have meant we've been able to be our true selves at all times, without fear of judgment or failure holding us back.
Speaking of failure, we're hoping this speech will be more of a success than our first Head Girl prayers back in September. We attempted to do a live stream but couldn't access the right Teams call and ended up running around the school in a panic trying to find someone to help us before the start of period one.
After a few tears, Mrs. Davies saved the day and we attempted to calmly deliver our assembly despite being out of breath with smudged makeup. So perhaps the fact that this is pre-recorded will be in our favour today.
And so now, standing here as the final product of Godolphin after 7 amazing years, we wanted to recount some of our favourite and most important experiences that have got us to where we are today and provided us with such special memories.
Our years at Godolphin began back down in Walters with the new girls' mocktail-making afternoon with Mrs. Lapp and Miss Avila. Not many schools would teach you how to put a sugar rim on a cocktail glass at age 11, but as you can imagine, we all loved it and bonded in our small year group of 18 girls from the start.
This was followed by daily dancing into the music channel in the sit at break time. This was long before the days of TikTok. And lots of trying to fit ourselves into lockers and just generally being allowed to have fun.
After 2 years in Walters, we made the much anticipated move to our next boarding houses, Cooper and Sayers, which no longer exists. Our year group doubled in size, and with the arrival into third year came the very exciting first solo trips into town, where we would undertake the weekly challenge of trying to buy the entirety of Poundland's chocolate and sweets section, and maybe trying a top or two in Topshop before rushing back up Milford Hill in time for prep session two.
Nowadays, it's very rare to catch anyone in our year walking into town. If someone has their car in school, the town trip becomes a road trip, unless we're just popping to the ever handy, ever popular co-op.
Another excitement of third year was the introduction of socials. We all got dressed up in our new look culottes, ready to welcome the mysterious Sherburn boys for a disco in Broome. But when the boys arrived, the nerves took over until somebody started a dance off and the night began. I think we can all also remember Flippy's unfortunate knee dislocation in the middle of the dance floor at the Eton social as well.
A personal highlight of mine in the third year was when I went to Australia on the exchange to Melbourne Girls Grammar School. It was very cool to meet so many amazing people and see what school is like on the other side of the world. I was amazed because all their learning was online and they all used laptops and had to hand in assignments virtually. And at the time, I wondered if we would ever have something like this at Godolphin.
Enter coronavirus.
Which we're not going to talk about.
Fourth year brought with it an experience that we will never forget, nor ever stop talking about. Both of us took part and managed to complete the 35-mile 10 Tours Challenge across Dartmoor. After many training walks and stops at the lovely Exeter service station, we made it to the event.
We charged our speakers, ready to sing copious amounts of Mamma Mia songs on the walk, and on the Sunday afternoon, both of our teams crossed the finish line. 10 Tours certainly taught me that I would never like to eat another porridge pot again, but that boiling the bag Dolmio pasta carbonara makes a mean supper. So thank you to Major Reval for the recommendation.
One of the things that makes Godolphin has got to be the lacrosse. Both of us have played in various teams for our whole time at the school, and it has definitely taught us to successfully work in a team and given us valuable skills both on and off the pitch.
Thank you to the PE department for always putting up with our loud and not always tuneful singing on the buses on the way to matches, and just generally being fun and supportive year in, year out, no matter what the sport was. One sport that I didn't quite manage to excel in was athletics, and I'm sad that I didn't get one last attempt at a final sports day this year. But perhaps that's for the best. I reread my second year school report the other day, and in the athletics section, it read, "Isabel was reluctant with the hurdles, but after an hour of trying, she finally managed to get over one of them." So once again, thank you to the PE department for your patience.
The fifth year brought with it our final year of wearing the beloved pinnies. Whilst our skirts got shorter and the school jumpers were replaced with non-regulation hoodies, much to Madame Daubeny's dismay, I think we were all very sad to see our pinnies go at the end of the year. But we were lucky to have a wonderful pinny signing day, which is just another experience which makes Godolphin so unique.
We were given free rein on decorating our pinnies, and some people really went to town with faux fur trims and ribbons sewn on in advance, whilst others just put paint handprints in questionable places.
In September 2019, we started in the sixth form, and it really is true what they say about the sixth form feeling like a new school. You move over the bridge and are given a lot more independence. It was our first experience having study periods in the day, and we were warned that we would be told off if ever found sleeping or in bed during these periods. So of course, we definitely 100% spent everyone working hard at our desks.
We've had some amazing experiences during our time in the sixth form. Some of our favourites have been our fabulous winter ball in the lower sixth, even though we did have a fire alarm halfway through the dancing, creating the first ever Ents film, our recent muck-up day, and of course our regular sixth form bar nights. Thank you to Mrs. Hallin and Mr. Powell for running those. We are once again sorry about the bad singing.
Although our years in the sixth form have been slightly interrupted by a certain pandemic, we have felt that Godolphin community throughout and continue to have regular catch-ups online, virtual quiz nights, and not forgetting all of our online lessons. We were so lucky to have such amazing teaching throughout our time at home. And I think now we all have a myriad of excuses lined up as to why our cameras are switched off on Teams. So, our first thank yous go to our year group. Guys, we made it! I think we've all learned that even with so much uncertainty and disappointment, we are all able to keep reasonably calm and carry on when we are not sure what the future holds.
We have so many special memories together from our time at the school. And whether you've been here since the first year or joined in the sixth form, you've formed part of a special year group which has created long-lasting friendships. So thank you for putting up with us as your head and deputy head girls. I simply don't know what I'll do without our year group WhatsApp giving me something to do every day. Seriously though, you guys have been amazing and we'll miss everyone so much next year. But good luck with whatever university course, job or gap year you have lined up next. You'll all be brilliant.
Another special thing about Godolphin is how well you get to know the teachers, especially in the sixth form. So next, we would like to thank our amazing teachers. Thank you for all that you have taught us, all the fun memories and lessons throughout our time here, and for getting us through the complicated exams process this year.
We're sure we can't always have been easy, and we're sure you've had to deal with a lot of meltdowns, but hopefully it's been a largely positive experience. We'll certainly miss you and your continuous support next year. I'd like to say a special thank you to the boarding staff. I definitely believe that Godolphin has the best housemistresses of any school, and I've loved every single night of boarding here. Thank you for all the fun memories you've given us all. All the activities, the chats and the biscuits have really got us through.
Talking of biscuits, thank you to Chartwells for not giving up on us after the great biscuit fight of 2019 and for always providing us with such amazing food. I think our year group will particularly miss not having a coffee shop on our doorstep at all times. Even if it is one that enjoys rebranding 4 times in 7 years.
Now a message for the girls. We'd like to say thank you for mostly turning up to prep when you're supposed to and for always being so much fun at school events. Please enjoy every minute you have left of Godolphin and don't take it for granted when things like assemblies and whole school gatherings return. It'll be amazing and we hope you love it when you finally get to see what non-COVID Godolphin's like if you haven't experienced it yet.
Godolphin really gives everyone so much freedom to try new things and to learn important lessons about yourselves. So have a go at everything and take some time to appreciate where you are because your time here will go far too quickly.
Thank you to the senior management team. A particularly fond memory we have of you all is the Christmas performance of Frosty the Snowman and other carols outside the PAC. It was in true Godolphin Christmas spirits that we gathered there with our phone torches before the Christmas holidays, and it was so brilliant. So thank you so much for that, but also thank you for all you've done for us as a school this year. We definitely couldn't have done it without you.
In particular, thank you to Mrs. Hattersley. We have loved our weekly meetings with you, and you are always ready with the right advice when we need it. Your leadership through these last couple of years has been greatly appreciated by everyone, and we feel very fortunate to have worked alongside you this year.
Finally, thank you to Godolphin. We will miss this school so much next year. The friendly and close-knit community and the amazing people have made our experience here unforgettable.
We will definitely be visiting regularly, so don't worry. This is certainly not the last time you'll see us. But for now, we wish everyone the best for summer and the future, and we'll see you soon.
Thank you and goodbye.
Before I announce next year's officers, I wanted to pay tribute to the outgoing head and deputy head girl and the prefects. Not quite the year they had planned, but they've been a supportive and effective team nonetheless. Led extremely ably by Izzy Gilligan and Harriet Lucas. Izzy and Harriet have been exceptional. Despite all the twists and turns, they've remained unfailingly positive and committed. I could not have asked for a more superb duo to lead the student body. So thank you, Izzy, and thank you, Harriet. You've been amazing. I'm delighted to announce that next year's head girl will be Clementine Boucher. Deputy head girl will be Lilibet Blythe. Congratulations to both of you. Head scholar next year will be Jessica Horsfield. Many congratulations to you, Jessica. House captains next year. For Douglas, it's Isabella Morgan. And deputy house captain is Georgina Way. For Hamilton, the house captain is Francesca Roberts. Deputy house captain is Alice Rusby. And for Methuen, house captain is Lottie Reeve. Deputy house captains are Amelia Heath and Jemima Bentley. Many congratulations to all of you. Well, I think today we should leave the last word to the Upper Sixth. Thank you to all of you for everything you've done for Godolphin. Go out into the world with purpose and with courage and with kindness and have wonderful lives. And we look forward to seeing you soon. Goodbye.
I can't believe that after 7 years at Godolphin, it's over and I didn't even get to properly say goodbye to everyone. But I just wanted to say thank you to all the teachers I've had and met. It's been a pleasure to know you all and I hope to see you again soon. Bye.
Hello to my lovely Matthew winners. Hello from me, hello from Digby, hello from Squeak. We're on here today to wish you well and to say good luck and thank you. To all the girls that are leaving Godolphin School today, I wish you well. And to our Methuen girls, remember Methuen for life. And when you go out into the world, think about that Methuen spirit, kindness, tolerance, and just being the loveliest person that you can be. Thank you particularly to my committee, who have worked really hard in what's been a difficult year. And I look forward to welcoming our new committee for the new year ahead. Have a lovely summer holiday. Take care, everyone, and look after each other. Bye. Bye.
I think I can say with 100% confidence that there is no other place like Godolphin, no other school like Godolphin. For the past 5 years, I don't think there's been one point in my life where I've thought, oh no, I need to get out of this place. But no, I've enjoyed every single second, literally every single minute I've spent there. And I hope when it's safe to do so, we can actually say proper goodbyes. But yeah, until then.
To the class of 2021, the way you have dealt with these last 2 years has been quite extraordinary. And so I want to wish you all the very best. Don't forget what we said. Keep growing, keep flourishing, keep showing everyone just how amazing you all are. And we wish you all the very, very best. Lots of love. Mwah.
Hi everyone, I just want to say a massive thank you to all my teachers who have ever taught me in my time at Godolphin and anyone who's just been around for a chat. It has honestly been so much fun and it's something I will miss so much. Anyway, it feels so weird to say this, but goodbye.
Thank you so much, Godolphin. It's been the best 7 years ever. I've made the bestest friends and I've had such a great time. I'm gonna miss you all so much.
Oh, hello. I was just collecting some bits and pieces together for the Douglas Textile Bank. Well, this is an opportunity for me to say goodbye to all the Douglas Leavers, Douglas staff, Douglas students. Thank you so much for everything you have contributed to Douglas. We're really going to miss you and we do hope that you'll stay in touch. Goodbye!
Can't believe we finished school, it's really weird. But I want to thank all the teachers, you've all been so, so amazing and I wish everyone the best of luck.
Godolphin has been a massive part of my life and I don't think any words can describe how thankful I am for the experiences I've had at Godolphin. I just want to say thank you to my fellow students who have made it so fun to be at Godolphin and also the teachers for all the life skills that I will carry on into my future and also the house staff and not forgetting Sister Jill who have always managed to pick me up when I've been down. I just want to say a huge thank you to you guys. Good luck for the future. Goodbye.
Hello, Hamiltons. I can't believe we're at the end of the year and I'm having to say goodbyes. I just want to say a massive thank you to all of you for keeping that house spirit, even when things have been really odd and different this year. I'm really hoping next year we'll be back together and celebrating. So have an amazing summer, but also goodbye to our upper six. I don't feel I've really got to see you this year, and I know there's been house prayers and things, but it's definitely not been the same. And I just want to say a massive thank you for everything you've done for the house over the years. Some of you have been in Hamilton for a really long time and done amazing things for your house. So thank you. That's the biggest thing I want to say, is a massive, massive thank you, and good luck with everything in the future. Bye.
Thank you to everyone who has made my time at Godolphin so much fun and so special and amazing. I've made some really, really good friends and met some really amazing people. And thank you to all the teachers for the help that they have given over the last few months especially. And yeah, I'm going to miss it a lot. So yeah, see you soon.
Thank you so much to everyone at Godolphin who has made my time there so special. I've met some great people along the way, including teachers and friends that I will remember for the rest of my life. Hope you all have a great summer.
Upper Six, it has been a real pleasure being your tutor and your teacher this year. I'm sorry we're not getting to say goodbye in person, but I'm wishing you all the very best for your time beyond Godolphin, and I really do hope you keep in touch.
I was actually thinking the other day, I can't believe I've been at Godolphin for 5 years. Actually, crazy. But no, I'm gonna miss the teachers so much. And you know, I've made some great friends, and it's just the whole school, to be honest. It's been an amazing experience and big, big part of my life. So yeah, I'm gonna miss Godolphin so much.
To all of you in my tutor group, I wish you all the best in the future. I've thoroughly enjoyed having you in my group and getting to know you all better as the couple of years have gone by, and just going through all those stages of seeing, planning, researching what your futures might hold. I've got no doubt that you will all go on to have thoroughly enjoyable careers, and I'll just say, follow your dreams.
Well done for all your hard work this term. Good luck for the future, and come back and see us soon. Have an amazing summer.
Hey everyone, I just want to say a massive thank you to you all for making my time at Godolphin so amazing. And I'd also like to thank the teachers, but I do hope that we can all celebrate together really soon.
I just want to say a big thank you to everyone who's made my 6 years at Godolphin so memorable. It's probably been the best 6 years of my life so far, and I'm so sad to be leaving. I just want to say a massive thank you to all the teachers who have been truly inspirational, and also all my friends on the way who've been there to support me. I'm really going to miss everyone so much, but hopefully we can see each other soon for a proper goodbye.
I'd like to wish all the Leavers the best of luck. I hope you get to travel far and wide and fulfil all your dreams. Good luck.
I have had lots of memorable moments throughout the 4 years in Godolphin. Thank you for all the support given by staff and students. Thank you. Bye.
Goodbye, Godolphin. Thank you for 7 years of incredible memories. I will never forget it. And a special thank you to the English, the classics, and of course the drama department. Thank you so much for everything you guys have done for me. It's been a blast. Bye.
I have really enjoyed my time at Godolphin. The experience here has been something you'll never get anywhere else. Lifelong friendships have been made. I've just loved every minute of it, and good luck to everybody in the future.
Okay, goodbye girls, goodbye from me. Yes, I'm leaving Godolphin. I've loved you all, as you know, and I've had the honour of knowing you from when you were little all the way up to being beautiful young ladies you are now. I'm wishing all of you in the sixth form the best in your future. You'll be marvellous whatever you do, I know you will. And to all the other girls that are leaving, the best of luck, you'll be brilliant. And to all the new Godolphin girls, welcome to the wonderful Godolphin family, for which I've been honoured to be able to share for the last 15 years. So goodbye, and from me to you, wishing you all my love.
Godolphin has been the best 7 years and given me the most amazing memories and the best of friends. I'll miss you all so much.
Goodbye, Godolphin. I can't believe we're leaving. I'm gonna miss everyone and everything so much. And thank you to everyone for making the last 7 years so special.
Bye, Godolphin.
Thank you, everyone, for amazing past 5 years, and best of luck for the future.
I have nothing but incredible memories of Godolphin. I'm going to miss you all so, so much. We had such an amazing year group, and I wish everyone the best for the future.
Bye, Godolphin. I can't believe 5 years of school have completely finished, and I'm so sad that this can't be in person. But I hope to see you all really soon, and yeah, bye.
I cannot believe this challenging year is finally over. Just want to say a huge thank you to the teachers and the whole of Upper Sixth for making this difficult year worthwhile.
Hi everyone, I want to say a massive thank you and goodbye to everybody. Thank you to the teachers, to the house staff, to everyone, all the girls. I've had an amazing year at Godolphin this year and I've loved every second here since I started. So thank you all so much for making it amazing. I hope you're all having a nice day today and I hope you all have a good summer. Hopefully I can see you all soon to say a proper goodbye, but for now, thank you so much and I'll see you soon.
I just want to say a massive thank you to everyone who's made my Godolphin experience as amazing as it has been. I've seriously loved every single minute of my 7 years here. I can't believe we're actually leaving. I'm so sad not to be there today to say goodbye to everyone properly, but I'm sure we'll get a chance in the future. So thank you to the teachers, the girls, the boarding staff, everyone who has done anything for me over the years. I've loved everything, so thank you so much. I'll miss everyone loads. Bye.
Hello, Upper Sixths. In what has been an extraordinarily difficult and challenging 18 months, it has been my absolute pleasure and privilege to have been your head of year. You've been resilient, patient, supportive, and accepting. And what's more, you've shown real determination and flair to spread your wings and take advantage of every opportunity. I'd like to thank you for your wisdom in leading the rest of the school, for your courage to do and say the right thing, and for your generosity of spirits towards myself and the rest of the staff and to the school as a whole. In a year like no other, even with the ups and the downs that you've all shared, you have ultimately supported one another, lifted one another when it needed to be done, and you've embodied as a year group what it means to be loyal to your school, to your friends, and to yourselves. We will miss you greatly. Good luck with all that follows, and remember that we are always here for you.